Hey, folks. Can you hear me okay? Yes. Okay, awesome. A lot of you know us. We've been kicking around in community for a while. I've done Prezos. So we're up here to talk about something kind of fun. Scaling MongoDB queries, but with Cassandra. So there's some interesting stuff going on there. Well said. So we made Cassandra compatible with MongoDB. And this came out of just sort of like a thought exercise, navel gaming situation one day. But, you know, the first thing I gotta say, you know, we're not proud of this. You know, it was experimental. We wanted to see if it would work. It was one of those things where we had this thing. And for those of you who don't know who we are, apogee.com or usergrid.apogee.com, you can take a look. We aren't gonna pitch anything vendor based. But take a look at that. And one of the things we realized was that a lot of our users were picking our solution because they didn't want to manage like a database or anything like that. They just wanted to have something where they could have object storage via REST endpoints. And we saw a lot of people come in who had problems with, particularly with MySQL administration or MongoDB replica administration. And like, when you look around, it's one of the things you see is that, and you can, and I'm picking on Mongo here a little bit, but you can do this with a lot of them. You start talking about Mongo scale or, you know, Redis scale or complexity, and you get a lot of interesting autocompletes. This is my favorite though, because like three of the ones on there are, you know, troll sites. But so what we did was we took what we had at UserGrid, which was essentially starting to look a lot like a document store, and we thought, well, what if we made this wire compatible with MongoDB? How much is going on there in their protocol and their query language? We have our own query language. We have our own query parsing grammar stuff. Take a look if you get a chance. It's all ASF licensed. So what we did was we just reverse engineered a protocol, and it turned out to be, it's a screwy protocol, first of all. But it was surprisingly easy once we got into it. And not everything's working. We have like a good deal of portions left to work on, but a lot of the CRUD does, and it's really interesting in terms of what's there. Okay, and we're gonna switch over to computer here, and Ed's gonna drive.
Thanks. So what we're doing here is we're running a open source GUI client called Mongo Hub that we just pulled off the net, hasn't been modified at all. I went and punched in some settings, configured it to point at one of our user grid instances over at Amazon, put in my credentials in which one of the databases that we want to hit here, went ahead and double-clicked on it and saw that actually I was able to go and get a list of all the collections associated with this application. I can go in and actually run queries if I want to go and click run. I'll see these are our standard, Mongo results, all being translated in from our native JSON format into Mongo's Bison format that gets interpreted by Mongo Hub. We can actually do queries, I believe, in Mongo's kind of odd query language.
So there's really no magic here. We really just, you know, built our interpreter, our JSON interpreter, to run on top of this, and, you know, away it goes.
There you go. So we don't support all of the Mongo commands yet, but we do parse all of their everything in their protocol. So it's only a matter of time if there's interest. Play with it and let us know, and we'll see how far we take it. But we think it's a pretty neat parlor trick at the moment.
We got one. Do text search. Oh. Yeah, we got one more. This is actually something you can't do on Mongo right now, and it's a severe limitation of the way their indexing scheme works. We have full text search working. So digging into your property here, and we're going to actually throw a name at it, new, we hope. And there we go. There's the results. You see new in there in the content, new in my new post, And we are almost out of time, but there you go.